Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you back to my YouTube channel, presenting before you this wonderful tutorial is Hans-Björk Lehmann. So today we are going to do some practice questions and vectors. And if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and also hitting the like button. Let's get started. We have a question saying a force F1 of magnitude 6 newtons acts on an object at the origin in a direction. So we have been given, let me just write our data somewhere. So accordingly to our data, the question says that we have been given a force F1 which happens to be 6.0 newtons. Then we have been told that it's actually coming at the origin, where our theta is equal to 30.0 newtons, sorry, degrees above the positive x-axis. A second force, which we are simply calling as F2, we have been taught that it is actually 5.0 newtons in the y-axis. Find the magnitude and direction. Okay, we have been told to find the magnitude. We also find the direction of this particular question. But when you look at this question, we can draw it properly in this way. We are going to have a line in the positive axis, y-axis. Then we also have a line in the positive x-axis. We are going to have this vector, which we're simply calling as our F1, and then we are going to have an angle theta, which we're simply calling as 30 degrees. Notice that we are going to have the x component and also have the y component. Now, let's try to compute this particular figure into its required components, because we know that F1 is equal to 6 newtons accordingly to the question. Let's begin. So we know that F1 has got two components, the x component and also a y component, which is going to be in this direction, like this. And of course, it's going to attain a negative figure because it's moving downward. Now, F1, x is going to equal to F1 cosine theta. So F1 x is going to equal to, what is F1? It is 6 cosine the angle theta, which is 30. So if we add that 6 cosine 30, we are going to get a 5.2 newtons. That is in the x-axis. Let's also try to get in the y. So F1 y is going to equal to F1 sine the angle theta. This is going to be 6 sine, what is the angle? It is 30. And of course, we're going to have 6 sine theta, sine 30. We are going to get a 3.0 newtons. That is in the y. All right, let's now try to compute the F2, which happens to be this force. Let's try to compute F2 into components. But notice that F2 only has one component, and that is the y component. There is no x because it is moving upward in the y-axis. So we're going to say that F2x is going to equal 0.0 newtons because we don't have any component in that direction. But F2y is going to equal to the same figure that we have been given in the question, which is simply a 5 newtons, 5.0 newtons. We can find the summation of the force both in the x and the y. So in the x we have, so we can simply say F x is going to equal to, we have 5.2 plus 0, and of course our answer is 5.2 newtons. We have supposed to be Fy. Sorry about that. Fy. So this is actually very simple. Fy is going to equal to, we have 3 plus, then we also have a 5, and of course we have 8.0 newtons. Let me just clear the board. Okay, so now we do have all the figures that we want. We can find the resultant. The resultant vector is going to equal to, is a to the power 2 plus b to the power 2. This is just some formula. So in this case, where there is a, I can put 5.2 plus 8.0, like that. This is going to give us, what is 5.2 to the power 2? This is going to be 27.04 plus 64. So if we add everything, this is going to be 91.4, and of course our resultant is going to equal 9.5 newtons. Direction is simply tan theta equal to the y component over the x component. Theta is going to equal to tan inverse of y over x. Therefore, we can replace in everything. Y, our y component is simply 8 over 5.2. Theta in this case is going to equal, let me just do my calculations. It's going to be 56.97, which is simply 57 degrees. That is just how you calculate this particular question. Let's get to the other question. If you have an idea concerning this question, try to pause this video and then try to find the answer. Well, let's get started. The helicopter view in figure 1.7 shows two people pulling on a stubborn mall. Find the single force that is equivalent to the two forces shown, and then the force a third person would have to exert on the mall to make the net force equal to zero. Alright, so I'm going to calculate the first question. And of course, if you calculate the first question, the second question is very simple, which happens to be. So make sure that you understand how I'm going to do the first question, then you'll be able to do the second. And of course, make sure that you inbox me the answer. Let's get started. So what we have is a diagram. This diagram is stationed like this. We have a force being put in this direction on the X. We also have another force being put in this direction. Okay, we have been taught that this force F1 is 120 newtons, and of course our F2 is 80 newtons. We have an angle theta of 60 degrees, and of course we have an angle theta of 75 degrees. Now what we're going to do is this. We know that we can compute everything into components. Vectors are very simple. Just learn how to compute everything into components. And if you don't know, make sure that you check my previous videos. We have this X component in this direction. We also have this component. Okay, we can call this is my X component. My X component, like that. Now, sorry, this is going to be my Y component. That's my Y component. My Y component. Now, what I'm going to do is this. F1, X is going to equal to 120 cosine 60. 120 cosine 60 is equal to 60 degrees. This is going to be 60 newtons. So we can simply say F1x is equal to 60 newtons. F1y is going to equal 120 sine 60. 120 sine 60 is going to equal 103. This is 103 newtons. We can say that F1y is going to equal 104 newtons if we round off. We get on the other side. We can also compute this into components. But check that F2y is going to be negative because it moves downward. And at the same time, okay, so sorry, so we have this guy moving in this direction, we have this guy moving in this direction. So you are moving in this direction, then you start climbing upward. So FY2 must be positive, but so we're going to have F Y being positive, then F2x being negative because it moves in the negative direction. Take note of that. So F2x is going to equal to, this is going to be 80 cosine 75. 80 cosine 75 is going to equal 20.7 newtons. Now this is going to be negative because we move in the negative direction. F2x is going to equal negative 21.0 newtons. How about F2y? F2y is 80 sine 75. 80 sine 75 is simply positive 77.3. It's a positive because it moves in this direction. Take note of that. Let me just keep my work neat. So we are going to have a positive 77.2 newtons. All right, let's just try to add up everything. Let me try to clear my board. Sorry. Okay. All right. Let's add up fx. Fx is simply the summation of all the forces in the x. So this is going to be 60 newtons plus negative 21.0 newtons. So summation of all forces in the x is going to equal, this is going to be 60 minus 21. And of course, we are going to have a 39.0 newtons. Summation of all forces in the y is going to equal to 77 plus 104 newtons. This is going to be 77 plus 104 is going to be 181.0 newtons. Let's now try to find the result. Let me just try to wrap my board. Okay. So now, let's try to now find everything. Resultant force is going to equal to, we can now get our 181 power 2 plus 39.0 power 2. Resultant vector is going to equal to, what is 181 to the power 2? All right. Let me just add up everything. So we have 34282. What is the square root of that figure? The square root of this figure is simply 185 newtons. That is our final answer. Now let's try to find the direction. Theta is equal to tan inverse of some y component over some x component. So in this case, we have tan theta. Tan inverse of theta, what is y? Y is simply 181 over 21. If we do calculate that, we are going to find, let me just punch this on my calculator. Our theta is going to be 83 degrees. If you found this video helping, consider subscribing and also hitting the like button. And of course, if you find this particular question, consider inboxing on +26 0777 66 40 46. Thank you so much.